Hello developers, I am back with another brand new video, and in this video we are going to extract colors from image and using it as a color in our application. And this is the final demo where you can see the scaffold background color is taken from this image, and based on the different image the scaffold background color will change. So if I will select another image, the background color of the scaffold will change based on the color of the image. So without further delay, let's get started. So I am going to start by creating a new Flutter project, and it will be of type application, and let's select the destination folder and I will name it Flutter image colors. Okay, so Flutter create is running. If you feel like boring or you will not understand the approach, it is too complex, then that is not the case. Code will be too simple and easy to understand. So stay tuned till end, and video might be long but not the approach and code. So Flutter create is done. So now let's remove everything from this and write from scratch. Void main, run app, and const my app. Let's create my app here, and let's import material.dart for run app STL, again using the snippet for creating status widget my app. And here instead of container, material app as usual. And in this app, let's do first thing, that is debug. So checked mode banner false. And in the title, let's give anything like image colors. Image colors. And in the body, not body here, I think here will be home. So in the home of material app, we will create the home page. So let's create a new file called home page. homepage.dart, and again using snippet to create stateless widget, it will be home page. And remove these imports. Here we will use image colors. So we have to again create this widget, but let's import first material.dart. Quick fix, import material.dart. And now finally let's create image colors. So image colors.dart, and this time it will be of type stateful widget, and it will be of name image colors. Again remove these two imports. I don't know why I always get that. Import material.dart, and here we need scaffold. And rest of the thing we will see later. So first let's import image colors in this home page. Add a const, but later we need something, so I am not adding const right now. And on this main.dart, import the home page, and here we can add const. Okay, so now it's time to implement the image color extraction feature. So for that we need to add one package, that is palette generator. You can see this is the popular package with 415 likes. So just copy it and add it in your pubspec.yml file here after Cupertino icons. Once it is done, you can run Flutter pub get, or on VS Code you can click on this download icon, and Flutter pub get is running. After that we can use the package. So here on the home page, in image colors we will need two things. First will be the image, and the second thing will be the size of image. I'm going to create two things here. Final image provider, why it is not okay, spelling is wrong. Final image provider image, and another thing will be final size image size. And let's add these two parameters. And now we need to pass that here. So for image we can use network image. You can also use asset image, but right now I'm going to use network image. And here we need the URL, we'll add later. And here the image size. So right now I'm going to give a constant size. You can give it based on your requirement. Size, and here will be like 256 comma 160. And here in the network image, I'm going to write list of image that will use here. So it will be like color images equal to, I have the list of cool images equal to list of images. So these are the images, and I will just use them like cool images of 0, one by one. We will see. Okay, so now we are done with home page, and now we have to use this package in image colors. So in the scaffold, we can write the background color. So background color, we will use that color from palette generator that is coming from the package that we just added. So let's create a state variable called palette generator. So we will use this palette generator here, but if the, in initial state, if there is no color, then by default we will use some color. So for that we need another color. So color default color is equal to, let's give it color start white. So if palette generator dot, we can use like there are many colors like dark muted colors, colors light muted colors, light vibrant colors. So for the better, like for extracting the most suitable color, we can use the vibrant color. So where is the vibrant color? So first we have to check like if palette generator not equal to null, because initially might this palette generator might be null. So if it is not null, then we will use palette generator dot vibrant color. But also there can be some case like in some of the images there is no vibrant color, so you need to also check like palette generator dot vibrant color not equal to null, then you have to use palette generator dot vibrant color. Otherwise use the default color. And here we have to write not, like it not will not be null here as well. So what is the error? I don't type object, constant from type color, palette generator not equal to null, then we are going to use palette generator then that vibrant color not equal to null, then we are again using palette that vibrant color, then here we need to write the color and again not symbol. So now the color is set. Here only we need to show the image like from which we will extract the color. So inside the body of this scaffold, let's write a column, and inside the children, or I think I can directly use in center, there will be child, and in the child of this center we can directly use image. And image, we have to provide three things. First, image will be widget dot image comma, we have to also give width and height, so we can give this from widget dot image size dot width, and for height we will use the widget dot image size dot height. Okay, so now we have to set the colors to this palette generator. So for that, let's create a function called generate colors. So void generate colors, and it will be like async because we have to await for generating color. And here we will assign palette generators to a new palette generator. Await palette generator dot from. Here are many options, but we are right now going to use from image provider because we are using the image provider here. So from image provider, and the image provider will be widget dot image, widget dot image, and we have to define the size and region. So size will be widget.imageSize, and we have to also create a region like on image from which region we have to select the color. So by default, if you want to use the entire region of image, then you can write something like react.from LTBR. So from top zero, from left zero, from top zero, from right, you can give the widget dot image size dot width, and for bottom you can give widget dot image size dot height. So it will cover approx the entire region. So it might get overflowed, then you will get error. So make sure you give the region within less than the size of the image, not more than that, otherwise you will get error. Okay, let's refactor it. Now let's see what we are getting. So first let's run the application and see what we have in the UI. So the application is now running. You can see this image in the center of this application, and right now it is taking the default white color because there is no color in the palette generator. So for generating the color from this image, either we can use init state and call this generate colors, or we can tap on this image and generate color. So for tapping on this image and generating color, we can wrap this image with a widget called inkwell, and on inkwell there is method called onTap. So onTap we can just call the update colors, generate colors. So onTap generate colors, and also we need to set state here because this is the stateful widget. Set state. Okay, let's see. So I'm going to click on this, and you can see now the entire scaffold color is updated. So now let's change the image and see what happens. So this time the vibrant color in the image is yellow. So as you can see, the background color is updated to yellow. Let's test for the another image. And yes, you can see everything is working fine. And you might be asking like, why only using we are using the vibrant color. So in the palette generator there are many colors. Only for the background, for the scaffold background, I am using the vibrant color. So right now we are using the vibrant color. So if you want, you can use any other colors from here. So let's use the dominant color and see what will happen. So first we have to check for dominant color and use the dominant color. So let's refresh, and you can see now the background color is coming from this image dominant color. So if I will change this image to, let's say, 0 again. Initially it is on default state, image is loading. If I will click on, you can see now it is taking the dominant color from this image. Like this, if you want all the colors, you can use these colors. If you want the dark muted color from the image, you can use this. If you want light muted color, you can this, you can use this. So like that, it is very easy to use any of the colors. But the like the perfect color for me was this vibrant color. So let's change it again to vibrant color. And if you want this background to update automatically based on the image, then you have to call this generate colors in the init state. So here in the inside the init state, remove this to do, just call the generate colors. And now if you will hot restart, your the scaffold background color will automatically change based on the image. So let's select another image and hot restart. Image is loading. You can see the background is changing automatically even without clicking on the image. So in this way you can easily extract different types of colors from the image and use it in your Flutter application easily. You can see like how easy it was to implement this. Only you need to take the palette and generate the colors from it. So that's it for this video, and I hope now you will be able to extract colors from images and use it in your Flutter application. if you have any doubt or you get some kind of errors, write down in comment. I will try my best to answer, and make sure to like and subscribe. Thank you.